All right, we had a leaning chimney here on the side of the house. I took a still picture of it before I tore it down. One right up through there. It kind of flared out on the side. I guess I zoomed in or zoomed out. There we go. That's a little better. Jesus. I don't know how that got that way. So anyways, that's where it's going up through. It had a little flare shoulders. It's just an oil burner on it. There was 8x12 flue in there, but the brickwork, we're not going back with 8x12, we're going back with a 6-inch round. So this stuff's kind of a pain in the bottom sometimes. They do make a contoured thimble. This piece is the thimble, goes through. I needed a 2-foot, but they don't make a 2-foot contour thimble, so you gotta kinda make your own. So I had to grind down the sides, cut the top profile, and notch out this other flue that it's going into, where the thimble comes in. There's a cutout for the clean out door. This is the old slate foundation here. Nothing but powder for most of it. So there's the other side we had to grind in the bottom. I'm gonna set this up and let it run for a little while. Maybe you guys can see kind of what's going on here. Yeah, I don't know. I guess you can see that. Guys and gals. So this piece is gonna come in. See, that's a nice fit. When I get up that high, we'll mud all that in, mud all this solid around that. This is kind of like just test fitting as we go here. Absolutely zero room to work right here right now, but hopefully it'll get better once we get up a little ways. Same thing again as on the other chimney I was telling you. A lot of white brick, all the extra colors and stuff I'm gonna put them towards the back. When we get up above this, when I get up on the wall there, I'm gonna run a half block every course, and that'll save a brick every course. But for now, this is what we're gonna do.
know what was behind the thinking of the first guy who decided to go slate over old wood shakes.
Right. Hey, that's the same way that my father's.
I know what the thinking was. Boy, we don't want to pull all them nails. Right. Let's just go over it.
But. Yeah, same way my father's shed there. It's all cedar shakes underneath. They just went right over the slate.
Pain in the ass when you're replacing slate.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, it's
they did it a lot.
It's quick and easy, you know. Even back then, they did it that way.
I'm not going to be around the next time.
Right? Leave it for the next guy. Again, this is all stick work again. I use a 4-inch grinder on these to cut the radius in this because it's nice and small radius on a 4.5-inch grinder with a 1/4-inch tuck point and wheel on it.
takes all the time, ain't it?
Oh yeah. We gotta put our clean out door in here.
Right, everything.
Mud under this here. Thank you. These are just old common brick that were on the chimney. And I saved a few to fill in around here. The thing, nice thing about brick is they suck the water right up and that thing will set up real quick here. Thank you. Look at that chunk of rock that was in that brick. Piece of quartz. Been in there a long time. Put it right back in the wall where it belongs to. I'm just filling in. You want it solid, it's got to be solid all the way from inside to where the thimble is here. So we're going to fill that all in, mud and brick chunks and whatever we can get behind there. Thank you. never seem to find the time. always a little tricky until you get a couple feet on, or at least a foot. The bricks move around, the level rocks back and forth off a little higher low spot on the brick. It's hard to get plumb until you get a, you know, 3, 4, 5, 6 courses on. And then you can really start plumbing it. I mean, it just, a lot of times, but you know, on this, when you first start off, just measure it, just measure and see what you're, see where you're at. So we're 19 5/8. That's good. Yeah. And as long as I know these back two lines are plumb, it's going against the house. There's all kinds of gap. The only tight spot I'm going to hit is right up here. And then the house is going way out of plumb that way. So I'm just going to kind of let it go with it a little bit. Because you can always trim and whatever against this corner to get take up any gap you got. So we're just going to run this back of it plumb and check for measurement that way and keep them kind of good. See, but I'm gonna cover this up in there. And also go in from the inside and smooth around it with a little mud. So this here is where the clean out door is gonna go. So you see I'm building that up. Got one more course up. It's 8.5 by 8.5. There's the door. So we got, but I won't put it in yet because all the mortar running down the chimney from doing the rest of it's gonna, it lands all over it. So I'll just leave the opening. You can see, I showed you that already, but so I'll put that door in after. I'm gonna fill this in like that around the flues. There's some block somewhere over there. But I'm gonna shut this camera off right now and get going, and we'll check back in later.